Hello team, welcome to ARPRO Academy once again. In today's session, we will be talking about final inspection and quality check in a workshop. As we all know, there are various inspections keep on happening as a daily activity of a workshop. For example, pre-delivery inspection, which we have recently spoken about it. Then there is a vehicle acceptance inspection when we receive the vehicle for service or any other activity from the customer. That is the pre-acceptance inspection. Then your accident repair inspection for preparing estimate and all. And in workshop at various stages, lot of inspections keep happening. And we also know the very important final inspection or quality check. Final inspection is a very critical activity in a workshop. Either it is in a service department or in body shop. In both the places where activity is happening on the customer car, final inspection is very, very critical. Why it is so? It is just because it ensures the kind of quality of this service product what we deliver to customer. So with regards to that, it becomes very critical. Now, what are all the, if we have to identify what is the purpose of, once again, if we need to understand what is the purpose of final inspection. There, one is, as I already said, to ensure the service product is of high order, to ensure that as a fallout of that, if it happens in that fashion, what you achieve is a great customer satisfaction. As a result of great customer satisfaction, you will have a loyal customer and you have a regular business to your workshop. So that will be the end result. Then what is the second thing, if we have to identify in this, what is the purpose it serves? It definitely serves in certain way, invisible way, in enhancing the revenues of the workshop. Let us understand how it can be possible. For example, during final inspection of the car, if the technician, the final inspector, finds out something which may not live up to its life till the next service, which was not part of the service, but due to some reason it has deterioration. If it notices that, then if that is told to service advisor to speak to customer for recommending that replacement, so that can be done. So that is one way of upselling. We can say that, but it is not upselling. In fact, we are ensuring the serviceability of the product from service to service with that kind of a period. Then, for example, if the repeat complaint, revisit of the vehicle is minimized by thorough final inspection, nothing goes bad in a short duration of time, so the vehicle doesn't come to workshop, that is also saving of revenue, because any repeat visit, we all know, incurs some kind of expense, the vehicle coming to workshop, the logistics involved, then your labor time which is put on the car to redo the work, sometimes it will also, you will have to extend some kind of a goodwill on spare parts also. So these are all drain of a workshop revenue. This can also be to large extent minimized with a grade final inspection. So now, what are the infrastructure required for final inspection in a workshop? See, for example, if it is a 10-bay workshop, I would like to advise with my kind of experience. For example, say if it is a 10-bay workshop, one person, that is one bay, should be totally dedicated for final inspection. If you have, when we come to bay productivity, when that subject comes, I will talk how the bay productivity should be calculated. So final inspection, as I said, also participates in revenue generation. It cannot be done in a place which is not dedicated for that fully. So there has to be a final inspection bay. And this final inspection bay, when it is there, it should have all the tools and equipment, test equipment, everything independent for final inspection only. They should not be running around on the service base to get some test equipment, do it. No. Then the time consumed for final inspection will increase. With that regards, the final inspection bay should have entire requirement which is needed to have a thorough check on the car. Then there has to be highly qualified manpower employed into that. The individual should have a keen observation, this thing, problem solving capacities, then test driving of the car. So these are all some of the qualities which a final inspector should have. Final inspection is not just looking at the appearance of the car, preparing for delivery. Many times it is mistaken like that. It is not so. Final inspection is purely a very authoritative kind of a job where they have to ensure that everything which is delivered from the workshop is of very high order. With that, to ensure that the manpower employed should also be of that quality. So now, what are all the activities of final inspection, if we have to say? Process. When we talk about activity, it is what is the process the final inspection should have. First and foremost, there has to be 100% final inspection from the workshop. There should be no reason why every car which is entering the workshop leaves the workshop without passing through final inspection. If we can always have a lot of good reasons for not doing so, but we have to find a way out wherein we ensure that every car goes through final inspection before it is handed over to customer. If we can build that kind of mindset, and I am very confident it is possible also. So please ensure that every car goes through final inspection before it is delivered to customer. This final inspection has to have a director be under HOD, the top man of the service department. It should not be working under anybody. Okay, administratively they should be with the system, but the technical this thing has to be with the top man, so that there is a good control of the final inspection. Then final inspection, most of the manufacturer have given checklist, or we can prepare one which is suits the entire checking of the car. So that final inspection check sheet has to be fully gone through as per the checklist. Then final inspection has to ensure that all the parts replaced in the car are physically fitted on the car. That is important. And the old parts, the replaced parts, are in the car, in a, put in a neat package. That they have to ensure. Then the final inspection has to ensure that the customer request on the job car are all carried out on the car. If there is anything which is customer has given as a complaint, that needs to have attended. Also, the final inspection should take care that all the jobs carried out are entered in the repair order. Why? Because if all the jobs is entered, the service advisor accordingly can put the labor rates or whatever charges required for that one. If the shop floor forgets to write mention something, possibly it may get missed out. That might be again a revenue loss. So the final inspection has to ensure all this endorsed correctly in the car. And finally, the final inspection has to ensure that the all the customer comfort areas are taken care. What do I mean by that? The clock is set, timing is set, date and timing is set, the infotainment is brought into the original condition of what customer choice was there. The seat of the car is put into the original requirement of the customer. So all these minor things should be taken care of by the final inspection team so that we deliver a very good product. One more thing I would like to say is this final inspection goes in three stages if I have to identify. One, the technician who does the job on the car along with his box manager or the team sees that the job is done as per the requirement. So he has to get the person who is working on the car, first has to get himself satisfied. Next, the final inspection, what we have discussed now. And the third is, service advisor should have a look around of the car that whatever he has taken request from the customer during acceptance, all those things are done in a proper way. He has to do. When these things happen in the fashion what I have explained right now, I am quite sure, and you will also agree with me, that we can minimize or bring the repeat complaint or the revisit of the car to 0%, which will be a great benefit in respect of customer satisfaction, also in respect of enhancing the revenue. Hope we all understand this, and we try to see that we do a great job in our day-to-day activity. Thank you very much. Be safe. Keep smiling.